Greetings. At Stardog, we help some of the biggest companies on the planet make better decisions with their data through our enterprise knowledge graph. By connecting data and bringing context and meaning to it, we help companies build innovative products, create efficient data-driven operations, and unlock access to their data that they did not know is possible through the technology of a knowledge graph. Well, what is a knowledge graph? Knowledge graphs power products you use every day. Things like Amazon Alexa, Google Search, Uber, Airbnb, all of these are powered by a knowledge graph. By connecting data within an organization and bringing that context and meaning, you can get better results from search, you can better target your queries, and you can leverage the data silos you already have. One use case of a knowledge graph that we've seen come up more and more is the concept of an emergent data fabric. Gartner has proposed this architectural principle of a data fabric at really looking at new ways to be able to deliver data, to search for data, and query data within your organization in order to minimize the human impact and need for data engineers and IT professionals in order to go accumulate, aggregate, and cleanse that data, as well as automate data discovery for new sources of data as they come in. In the context of this data fabric approach, Gartner has identified one of the most important capabilities as a knowledge graph. Having this connected set of data, understanding your data usage patterns, the quality of the data, along with direct access to the data where it lives, provides for a more dynamic integration architecture and allows the data fabric use case really to be successful beyond more traditional approaches. Only by looking at connected data, both metadata and the data itself, are companies able to be successful at really moving away from the traditional ETL data engineer and IT-led processes around data delivery. So how does Stardog work? What do we do that really makes this capability of a knowledge graph obtainable and achievable by our end customers? At our core, Stardog has a native semantic graph data store. We have the ability to store, to read, and to represent data using the power of a semantic graph. This flexible approach to being able to store a model and data separately but connected within the same repository allows data to be represented in a way more reflective of real life and less focused on the technical requirements of how data needs to be stored within a repository. But we go much beyond that. That's really a starting point for looking on how to achieve this concept of a knowledge graph. The next capability we think is very important is the idea of data virtualization. When we had customers that were trying to adopt this graph technology, one of the largest issues that they ran into was they had to move all the data out of their existing repositories into yet another silo. And by developing this proprietary data virtualization capability, we have the ability to represent data from applications, things like Salesforce, ServiceNow, Spelunk, your existing databases, things like Oracle, DB2, SQL Server, as well as unstructured data and semi-structured data, things like MongoDB or Postgres or Cassandra, without having to move it. This allows queries to come in from enterprise applications, from reports, from business intelligence tools, where Stardog will look at that within the context of the semantic graph and take that semantic layer, translate those queries to something that is then federated out to the downstream systems, leveraging the data where it is, pulling back the results, and delivering those results to those applications that are requesting it. So being able to unify these queries and leverage investments made in existing infrastructure, compute, and applications, we're able to deliver this connected data set faster and at a lower cost than any of the other approaches on the market. So when do you use a knowledge graph? When's the right time to adopt this type of technology? Well, we've seen four types of problems really repeat themselves in our customers over and over. And we see them as ways to really identify whether a knowledge graph is right for you. The first is when you have very connected data, but very siloed data. When you have your customer data, your product data, your risk data, your infrastructure data, all in different applications and different data silos, but a need to be able to search across and query across all those sources to get a unified picture of your organization, then that's where Stardog and a knowledge graph can really be a good fit. When you have very diverse data structures and data types and different types of timeliness of data, when you have things like sensor data coming in at very high speeds, coupled with maybe product information or customer information that isn't moving very quickly, both of which have very different shapes to the data, knowledge graphs can really help decompose all those data structures and connect them in ways that would be difficult to do in their raw data formats. We've seen customers that have a need to quickly link and unify concepts across multiple data sets, where it's not about bringing all the data together, but really about showing how that data is connected and answering questions in a more unified fashion across those data sets, across maybe publicly available data, as well as data within an organization, regardless of where that data lives or regardless of where that data came from. The last case that we've seen is really where there's a need to uncover and use indirect or hidden relationships. When you're talking about a friend of a friend relationships, where you're looking about how are these things connected in a way that's not obvious, and we may not have an explicit connection in our existing data repositories. Stardog and our inference and machine learning can help uncover these relationships, and the power of a knowledge graph really allows you to deliver that, again, without having to move your data and being able to leave your data in the location that exists today. Let's take a look at how this technology can be applied inside a particular market. Inside of life sciences, some of the biggest pharmaceutical companies of the world are using our knowledge graph in order to identify more promising drug targets, to bring more pharmaceutical therapies to market faster, to better understand their supply chain and where there can be issues in their supply chain in order to be more successful and profitable as a company. They're doing this by unifying data silos that have existed within the organization for years. Different labs representing their data in different languages or using different code names for the same compound can be rationalized by a knowledge graph and reported on and queried against using a common language and a single meaning. Being able to look at this unified data across the organization without large ETL jobs to migrate the data by leveraging the data sources where they are, we really see these pharmaceutical companies transforming how they do business. And that's represented in real change for how quickly they can deliver their products to market and how well they understand how those products, even after they've become commercial and delivered to market, are moving through the supply chain and making it to people like you. Financial services organizations are using this technology to help bring a fuller picture of their organizations from end to end to understand their risk, to identify fraud, and to better comply with regulations. By understanding not just what servers does someone have access to, but what types of data and what application runs on that server. By looking at what the implications are if a particular machine or particular switch goes down in their organization. By looking at patterns in trades to see where is those patterns being repeated previously and better target fraud, they're able to use the contextual information from a knowledge graph to look at this connected data throughout their organization without having to create another data silo and create more ETL jobs and move data around. So we've really seen a huge investment in these organizations around the idea of a knowledge graph so that they can understand what is happening in their organization with meaning behind it without having to reinvest in another type of large scale data platform. So what is it that Stardog brings that is different and special that allows our customers to be successful at implementing knowledge graphs? I really see three core capabilities that Stardog has that sets us apart in the market from other providers. The first is our virtualization capability, being able to leave data where it is and yet still be able to query across it, leveraging the power of graph is a huge advantage that is not replicated anywhere else in the market. The second is our semantic graph technology. By bringing a semantic layer that we can lay across the data and represent it as it is, we can query data from very diverse different data sources and bring back a consistent, coherent, singular answer. And by using the power of ML and logical reasoning, we can bring new concepts and new connections out of the data to be able to deliver more value than just the sum of its parts. Data virtualization really allows you to leverage the power of the graph without having to repeatedly copy the information into yet another data source. This brings two primary advantages. The first is time to market. You can get your data into the repository without having to go through all the work of extracting it out, and you can iterate continuously on how do you want that data to be represented within the repository without having to continue to reformat, re-cleanse, and remove the data. So really being able to connect the data and thereby deliver an overall solution faster is the key value proposition around data virtualization. But beyond that, the ability to be able to look at the data as it is at this moment, to not have to worry about data latency, but to really understand that I can write a query and it represents this moment in time in those underlying data sources, brings a new level of timeliness to data acquisition by end users, data analysts, and data scientists than was previously available through traditional ETL approaches. The semantic graph really allows you to bring a metadata-driven abstraction layer over all of your data sources to allow you to bring meaning to that data without having to reformat it, to spend a lot of time tagging and labeling information, and be able to drive that into the data where it is today. Because of the fact that this is a layer and not a reformatted set of data that you need to continually be copying and managing and transforming, you can have multiple schemas that you would represent within the semantic graph to give different points of view and different meaning to different stakeholders. You can provide the data in the language that their customers are used to consuming it from and not have to force people to adopt to a technical infrastructure that is necessary for delivering the data. So this semantic technology really transforms how data delivery and data searching is done throughout an organization to allow people to use words and meanings and concepts that is more relevant to them regardless of where the data lives or how it's currently formatted. Inference and machine learning allows you to bring new relationships and new context to the meaning that did not previously exist. By leveraging the structure of the data, by understanding that certain concepts, you know, inherit other concepts. I know that states always belong to a country. And thereby, why do I have to write out the country data for every single address I have? If I know the state or I know the province, then I can infer the country that it belongs to. by being able to create declarative rules, to bring business rules and business meaning into your data. What's a high value customer? What's an expert on a certain technology? By bringing that into declarative rules, I can now search on those attributes and those concepts without having to physically instantiate them within the data and to continually have to manage any changing definitions for those rules. So inference and machine learning really brings a way to open up the data that is unified in the semantic model, leveraging the virtualization capabilities in order to bring these new connections and new meanings that did not exist previously within your organization. Well, thank you so much for watching this video. If you'd like to learn more about how Stardog can be applied to your unique set of problems, please contact us at sales@stardog.com or feel free to visit our website, www.stardog.com.